generally employed. So there has been the change in the share of their sectors in GDP. Sectors in GDP, but a similar change is not visible in regard to the employment. There are a change in a sectors, primary, secondary, and tertiary sectors. It has a gradually change in all the three sectors, but a gradual change is not occur in a employment opportunities. Most number of employment, it generally as provided by the primary sector in India, but when we are comparing the other countries of the world, other developed countries, developed countries, where the secondary and tertiary sectors, they are providing us more job opportunities. More job opportunities. But in developing countries, the primary sector continues to be the largest employer. When an economy grows, it offers the more and varied employment opportunities. The people tend to shake off their traditional dependence on agriculture, then they run out to cities and urban areas for the search of job opportunities in secondary and tertiary sectors of the economy. As the result, the relative significance of different sectors in the employment situation of the country, it changes. In the Indian economy, when we're talking about the Indian economy, which is as a developing economy, it also similarly changes have been in evident. The rate of a change is very slow occurring in Indian economy. Change means as a movement of a people from a primary towards as a secondary and tertiary. That change is a slower in Indian economy. That rate of change is a slower in Indian economy. For example, there are a 70% of job opportunities, approximately a 70% job opportunities provided by the primary sector, 10% job opportunities provided by the secondary sector, and 20% of job opportunities provided by the tertiary sector. It is a time between of a 1950s towards as a 1980. Then change occur. Such kind of a change, it slowly occur. People, they left their agriculture fields and modify or the transform their sources of the livelihood towards as a secondary sector. They set up their own small scale and cottage industries for increasing their earnings. Because decreasing size of agriculture fields, it directly influenced the production. In generation to generation, when the land divided among the children, it resulted as the decrease in production. So from a smaller agriculture field, how to obtain as maximum production or increase as the earning? For this, they changing their occupations from agriculture towards poultry farming, dairy farming, small scale industries, cottage industries, which are the more beneficial as compared to agriculture. People who are employed and people who employ, as well as the people who are self-employed, are all treated as the workforce of the country. People which are employed presently, first people which are employed and people who employ as well as self-employed. Self-employed, they already generated their own sources of employment. All these are constitutes under the workforce of the country. So people who are willing to work at present wages is known as employed, and people which are willing to work at present wages but unable to find a jobs, unable to find the jobs is known as the unemployed. They are ready to work at present wages are set by the Minimum Wages Act. For example, a construction worker in a presently it has earns 400 rupees as in day, in a day. So those which are ready to work as at present wage rate and but unable to find the jobs are the unemployed. They are unemployed. So such kind of unemployed, when they are not getting the jobs, they are dependent on a primary sector which are known as a disguised unemployed. Disguised unemployed are underemployed. Disguised unemployed is a situation in which more people are employed as compared to their demand. Disguised unemployment is a situation in which more people are employed as compared to their demand. The removal of an extra workforce from production sites, neither influenced the production. There will be as a no change in a production, no change in production by removal of an extra workforce from working sites. It generally has occur. This is disguised unemployed are generally occur in a primary sector. They occur in primary sector. So it is a situation in which the more persons are working on, they are working on a piece of land, then are the required. If a few of these persons are removed from the production sites or a land, this would not adversely affect the agriculture production. Why? Because land is the same, soils present on that particular agriculture fields are the same, then the production, it will not influence by the increase in the number of a workforce. Increase in number of a workforce not influence the production. But if we increase the number of the workforce in a secondary sector, in industries, it is gradually influence the production. So disguised unemployed are not generally lies in a secondary sector. They are only lies in a primary sector. So when more people are employed in a job than actually required, they are called as a disguisedly unemployed. So this situation is found in the, as compared to this, as the other situation, which has found in urban areas where the thousands of casual laborers, they search for the daily employment. They are employed as the painter, plumber, electricians, masons, construction workers, carpenters. Many of them do not get work every day. These people earn very little. These people, they generally earn very little, very little. They have to do it because they have to do, sorry, they have to do it because they have no other choices. These people are known as the underemployed. This kind of the underemployment is hidden in contrast to the someone who does not have a job and is clearly visible as unemployed. Now, how can we create as a employment? Unemployed are there, different number of unemployed are there. Some are the disguised unemployed. Some here are the educated unemployed are there. Those which completed as their professional degrees, but as per their degree, they are not getting the jobs. They are not getting a job. For example, a civil engineer, which is spending as a 4 to 5 years in their engineering BTech degree, after completion of their degree, they are earning as a 10,000 to the 15,000. Under such circumstances, they are not ready to work with such people, which are as the construction workers. As per the minimum wages, construction worker daily has a 400 rupees earned by the construction worker. 400 into as a 30, 12,000. 12,000. So there is a one elite person which has earns as a 12,000. In the other side, as a qualified graduate, B.Tech graduate is there, civil engineer, which has also earns as a earns 12,000 to 15,000. So under such circumstances, the individual, such individuals are not ready to work. They are known as a educational unemployed. Educational unemployed. Some are the structural unemployed. Structural unemployed. Who are these? Due to the introduction of a machinery in a production sites, which led to the removal of the workforce, is a structural unemployed. These are also known as a technical unemployed. Technical unemployed. They are ready to work, but due to the use of machines, mechanization in agriculture, machines in industries, it reduced the manual work. It reduced manual work, which is known as a technical unemployment. Technical unemployment. Some here as the seasonal unemployed. Seasonal unemployed. When a person has getting the jobs in a particular months of the year is a seasonal unemployed. Seasonal unemployed. In agriculture sector, people are seasonally employed at the time of a growing and a, sorry, at the time of a sowing and harvesting season. At the time, during the time of a growing period, people, the farmers, they are not employed the workforce. So large section of a workforce is still unemployed during the growing period. During the growing period, this seasonal unemployment has also lies in industries. Industries, hosiery industries of Ludhiana, hosiery industries of Ludhiana, which generally as producing the hosiery goods, gloves, socks, jackets, jersey, sweater, such kind of the products during the winters, just the beginning of the winters. During the summer, such people, they are, such industrialists, entrepreneurs are not employed the people. They are not employed the people. So people generally as employed during the time of a winters. Winters. Clear? Presently, as a sowing period of a paddy is going on, for which a large section of, large number of a people, they brought from a Uttar Pradesh, Bihar for the sowing of a paddy plant, rice plant. Clear? Now, how can we create as a more employment? How can we create or to solve the problem of unemployment? How can we solve the problem of unemployment? How can we solve the problem of unemployment? As per the existing infrastructural facilities, as per the existing infrastructural facilities, there infrastructural facilities, there are large scope, a vast scope for the increasing the job opportunities, increasing the sources of employment in economy, increase in a source of employment in economy. These services improve the economic environment. They provide as a conditions suitable for caring and economic activities. Entrepreneurs are attracted by the improved conditions. They are attracted by the improved conditions and sound infrastructural services. Sound infrastructural. Infrastructural means as a growth of a means of a transport, communication, trade, marketing, insurance, infrastructural facilities, and they come forward to undertake more production and manufacturing activities. Manufacturing activities. The employment opportunities are generated in the country. The employment opportunities which are generally created in the economy in a country like as India, which is known as a developing economy, there is always a good demand for goods and services. There is shortage of capital in the country. Shortage of capital in government. So such shortage of finances in a government, it has complete through the foreign direct investment, FDI. It is generally complete through the FDI, foreign direct investment. Foreign direct investment. Foreigners, foreign investors, they generally invest. Those who want to invest in India, but they feel as a discouraged due to the lack of infrastructural facilities. Lack of infrastructural facilities. That's why the present, all the state governments, they are basically emphasizing over the growth of trade, transport, roads, and banking services. And banking services, which provide as a supportive base for the growth of economy. Growth of economy. We can attract a direct foreign investment facilities like as a better roads, uninterrupted power supply, country-wide communication system, water supply, which can promote the expansion of expansion of it can provide as it can promote the expansion of expansion of trade within the country as well as the outside the country, which ultimately enhance the opportunities of employment. We know that there is unemployment is generally found in an agricultural sector. Underemployment is generally found in an agricultural sector. There are farmers who hold the smaller agricultural fields, which have no assured irrigation facilities. If government comes to their help or banks provide loans for the constructing wells for the irrigation, they will be able to irrigate the land and increase the production. Then they will emphasize over the such kind of a crops which will beneficial for them, more profitable. Presently, as agriculture is done by the people as subsistence for the survival of their families. They are neither emphasizing over a commercial farming. If we provide as assured irrigation facilities and loans, the facility of a credit with the help of a banks and insurance, banks and a government, with support of a government, then the number of a job opportunities, it can be as increased with production of a such crops which are demand in a agro-based industries. Here we produce as a product in a product oil seeds in agriculture sector through the assured irrigation facilities, which can use as a raw material in other factories in a small scale centers, where through crushing of such oil seeds, oil it can as obtained a number of a workforce it can employ. And when the number of products, it will be as an increase in our markets, then simultaneously there will be as a control over inflation also. Control over inflation. So along with the water, we need to provide the cheap agricultural credit to farmers to enable them to buy high yielding varieties of seeds, agricultural inputs like as fertilizers, insecticides, purchasing of the agricultural machinery. For this, cooperative societies are generally work in present. If any of a farmer which wish to purchase as a tractor, combine, thresher, harvesters, there is a subsidy. 20% of subsidy has given by the government of India to the such farmers which are purchasing the agricultural appliances. agricultural appliances. But this is not as a mandatory. Every person, it's not mandatory for every person to purchase the agricultural appliances, agricultural machinery, because cooperative societies, they are also giving the such machinery on rent basis to farmers. Rent basis to farmers. It's for the such kind of farmers which own the 2 to 5 acres of land. 2 to 5 acres of land. For a such kind of small agriculture fields, farmers did no need to go for a credit. They can utilize, they can complete their needs of a agriculture machinery with the help of a cooperative societies, which are lending, which are giving as a machinery on a rent basis for a certain period of time for tilling, plowing, and leveling the land. Clear? Is that clear? So there are several fields where a lot of work is to be done, such as the education, health, sanitation, housing, roads, railways, power, telecommunication, piped water supply, sewage system, solid waste management, etc. Such kind of the services are also the one of the other aspects through which as job opportunities can increase. Job opportunities, it can increase and to eradicate the unemployment. Eradicate unemployment. Clear? Except them, there are some number of governmental schemes are there, which you read in last year in third chapter of economics, poverty alleviation programs, in which the one as Manrega, Mahatma Gandhi National Rural Employment Guarantee Act, It was initiated by the government of India in 2005. Yes, anybody? What were the objectives of NREGA? Raise your hands. Jasnur Kaur. Jasnur from 10th D. What were the objectives? Raise your hand. 33% of job opportunities procured for women. Third, employment opportunities preferably given to the SC/ST communities, scheduled caste and scheduled tribe communities, Baljinder Kaur, Baljinder, raise your hand. Baljinder Kaur. As the unemployment alliance has given by the panchayats to the unemployed, if they fail to provide job opportunities within 15 days, unemployment alliance for the survival of the workforce, berozgari bhatta, a small amount of money has given by the panchayat for the survival of unemployed. This is known as unemployment alliance. Clear? So the Manrega, it was initiated in 2005. In 2006, Sampoorn Grameen Rozgar Yojana. Rozgar Yojana, National Food for Work Program, same year 2006, National Food for Work Program. This scheme, it supported to the Manrega. This scheme supportive for Manrega, which was initiated in 2006, in which those unemployed which employed by the panchayats, they generally paid in the form of a food grains. Food grains, neither as the currency. Money, it was not given to the such individuals, basically as a food items, grains, wheat, rice, given to them for their survival. Understood? Is that clear? Till there, any questions? Any questions? So any of the questions related with the primary, secondary, tertiary, their interdependence, their interrelationship, their role in the economy, and how they provide as a different job opportunities. The job opportunities generated by the primary, secondary, and tertiary sectors. Primary, secondary, and tertiary sectors. Any doubts regarding it? Yes, Princey?